when 55-year-old Anna Godfrey, a much-loved wife and mum who seemed to have it all, decided to take her life. Her family had no idea what was going through her head. Demons, witchcraft, a belief she was cursed. Her husband and daughter say she was brainwashed. The people responsible for peddling those beliefs, as Janet McIntyre discovers, make no apologies for the way they influenced Anna and the way they continue to put vulnerable people like her at risk.
Hello, everyone.
I hope you're having a nice day at the stadium and I love you.
I feel so much love when I look at photos of her. I just see my life. You know, she was just everything.
Marita Godfrey, so like her mum in her looks, in her ways.
We have a lot of similar qualities, like two peas in a pod, they used to say. Just both, you know, really caring people and down to earth, sensitive. Yeah, all the good qualities.
But as close as they were...
I don't think there was a day that went past where we didn't tell each other we loved each other.
There were things Marita didn't know about her mother, Anna, that she was severely depressed, in a dark place, and desperately unwell.
I think she tried to protect me from what she was feeling. I just had no idea what she was battling with.
Anna turned to so-called soul healers in New Zealand and overseas, paying them thousands of dollars for dangerous advice. People including this man, who, until now, has not been held to account for what happened to Anna.
Do you take any responsibility for the way she was feeling in those days leading
up to
her
death?
No,
I don't take responsibility for other people's life. It's up to an individual to take responsibility for their own life.
You brainwashed her to believe that
Excuse
she was
me?
Plagued
Excuse
with...
Excuse me? I brainwashed her? What planet are you on? Show me evidence of brainwashing. I want to see one piece of evidence on brainwashing. Really, I brainwashed her? Come on, you can't be that stupid, Janet McIntyre.
To those looking in, Anna's life seemed bright, with her husband Chris heading into retirement, a brand new home in the Manawatu.
Come on, boy.
Hey, and her animals.
Come on. Good boy.
And we was just going to the next stage of our life. And everybody was happy for us.
Engineer Chris Godfrey. They'd been together 35 years.
Anna was the love of my life. She's just a wonderful person.
Even in some of her messages, she was saying how much she was crazy in love with you.
Yes, yes, and likewise. We were just together. We were just together.
Their much-loved only child, Marita, arrived after 10 years trying to conceive her.
And she just doted on Marita. It was a life.
A lot of people used to say you're really lucky to have a mum like her. And I knew it. I didn't need telling.
Anna also doted on her own parents. And when she lost them both within a couple of years, she struggled to climb out of her grief. First with medication and then turning to people who claimed to be able to heal her soul.
What do you now know was going through Anna's head?
That she was really struggling and she was saying, I need help, I need help. And she was getting the replies back, no, you don't need help, you can do this yourself.
Good boy, Missy.
Spared her mother's misery, Marita, a vet nurse, had no idea at the time the real reason her mum turned up at work one day in July 2017.
Looking back now, I knew she was saying goodbye. We used to do this little hand squeeze like three times and it would mean I love you, and that's what she did. And I watched her walk away.
Do you think that she'd made her decision?
Yes.
In a note Anna left before she took her life, she said she felt like a tortured animal. It's hard to imagine how Anna shielded her family from her pain. But there were two people she confided in, people she paid to give her advice, who told her to resist medication and to deal to what they said were curses, the that were causing her problems. Those people, so-called soul healers, were criticised at the inquest into Anna's death. Sunday's learned that one of them, a New Zealand woman, is continuing to offer the same kind of advice to vulnerable people. We went undercover to see how she operates.
I mean, I do monthly healing sessions, and probably over the last year, it's probably about 20, 30, 40 people I've had, both men and women, and they're New Zealand and overseas as well, yeah.
The woman we'll call Jill has been given name suppression from the coroner. She has no medical training, claims to be psychic, and discourages medicine. In a phone consultation we've arranged, she tells our actor she cures people of depression by clearing their souls.
Most of my 99% of my clients, most of them do not have depressive thoughts anymore. They are positive. They wake up in the morning and they've never felt so good in their life.
No medication.
Yeah, no medication whatsoever. Medication, it's like, oh, well, I want to say it just coats you. It's not actually dealing with the actual cause.
Yeah.
Just as she told Anna Godfrey, Jill tells our actor the reason she's unwell is that she's cursed.
And you've got witchcraft and spells and that sort of thing on you, so it's no wonder that you're feeling weighed down and life isn't 100%.
Jill learned how to be a so-called master healer 2 years ago in the Philippines from this man, American Ed Strachar, who apparently has the power to transform lives.
And the reality is there's infinite energy around you, around me, around us.
Jill was among these students who each paid Strachar around $30,000 for a one-week course. Jill remains one of his biggest fans.
If I truly didn't believe in this type of healing, then there's no way I would have invested a huge amount of money to actually learn to teach and heal like Ed does.
Yeah.
Fresh out of healing school and back in New Zealand, Jill began to help her struggling longtime friend, Anna Godfrey.
I think she was trying to get Mum to fix herself, basically. And by doing that, healing her soul and not relying on medication, doctors, counselling.
Up next, Anna's devastating diagnosis.
Anna was attacked by witchcraft, serious witchcraft. There were really dark, demonic circles in and around somewhere there that had targeted her.
Can you imagine how hurtful this would be for her family?
Are we dealing with hurtful or are we dealing with truth? Did you come here to learn the truth or are we going to tiptoe around what really may have been?
Sedona, Arizona is a tiny town built on red rock and promises of miracles. The perfect hangout for a so-called soul healer.
It's billed as a cosmic wonderland, a place where people come to heal and to become calm. It's said the Earth's vibrations are so powerful here, you can absorb them. And it's here we meet a fully charged Ed Strachar.
Against this cinematic backdrop, the set for countless Western showdowns, and with his own film crew in tow, there's bravado in the air.
I've helped thousands of people here, and I helped Anna, and that's written and documented, but you don't seem to want to focus on that.
Depression, bad knees, even cancer. Ed Strachar claims to be able to fix it all, and it's simple.
Love is what heals. Got that? Love is what heals.
Why don't you go and heal everybody? Heal the world.
If the world came to me, that's possible. The world hasn't come to me. The reality is I can heal one or 100 or 1,000 or 1,000,000 all at one time, provided they follow my instructions. People do tragic things.
Armed with so much self-belief, Ed Strachar is ready to fire. A New Zealand coroner who hasn't contacted him has implicated Strachar in Anna Godfrey's suicide.
It's interesting that some incompetent fool is trying to put her suicide on me. That's what I find interesting and fascinating. You're trying to tell me that someone from thousands of miles away who helped Anna with love and healing caused a suicide? Come on, nobody could be that stupid.
So if you had been contacted by the coroner, would you have responded?
Of course I would. Why wouldn't I?
Would you have been happy to answer questions?
Why wouldn't I? I'm answering them now, aren't I?
To help us with those answers, and in a quieter moment, Ed Strachar offers to show us his work.
So you're going to demonstrate some kind of process, some kind of healing process, that you say is going to heal people watching this?
Well, they'll feel the energy. Whether it heals them has a lot of other factors, but they will feel the higher love. You follow?
This is his tool of trade.
Okay, so this, if you feel, is just, you can hold it, is just what we call a bobber. It's a piece of metal on a stick. However, I'm connected to higher dimensions. And then I'll say, show me a yes. Show me a no. See, so a yes is vertical, and a no is horizontal.
On the other end of the line, he says, talking to him, are the celestial spirits.
Andromeda, Milky Way. All beings are aligned with the highest levels of love in the universe. Are you with us? All right. Remove any dark energies. And those could be
volunteer Brian, his cameraman, has been suffering relationship angst.
And let's transform all that into love and see and feel it transform.
But Ed Strachar says he doesn't need to be here in psychic central USA. He doesn't even need face-to-face contact.
I've developed my ability to heal people around the planet and just by the internet.
On Skype and on Facebook, from a luxury resort in the Philippines where he's based, he diagnoses people like Anna Godfrey.
Anna was attacked by witchcraft, serious witchcraft. There were really dark, demonic circles in and around somewhere there that had targeted her.
How do you know?
Draining
that?
Her soul. That's what I do. I can sense that. That's what I do.
So in Anna's case, who are the witches?
Oh, I can't answer that. I can't give you names and addresses. I can just say that's who casts spells and curses.
These are physical witches?
Yes, physical witches. Hillary Clinton's a witch, a sixth-degree Illuminati witch. So is Angela Merkel. The queen is the head witch on the planet. Okay, this exists.
And witches, he says, targeted Anna.
From all reports, Anna was a lovely woman.
Beautiful soul.
No one can say an ill word about her.
Beautiful soul.
Who would want to cast spells like this on her?
I got news for you. Beautiful souls is who they attack the most.
His own soul was attacked once, he says.
I want you to look up at the ceiling, smile, and rub your chest.
In the early 90s, he was here in New Zealand and all over the world, flogging a speed reading system, which eventually went bust and led him to thoughts of suicide.
I had $20 in my pocket, but I could walk to the local hardware store and buy a rope. And that thought was coming to me loud and clear. Who was putting those messages in my head? Demons, witches, sorcerers. Those were curses.
Hello, I'm Ed Strachar. Those who know me...
He reinvented himself as a healer and, as we discovered, with a side interest in photography, using the pseudonym Ed Davidson.
Is that bad? Do you not have any people like that in New Zealand that like photography and do photography of pretty girls?
But his core business for 6 years has been selling the promise of miracles to vulnerable people like Anna. And as her daughter Marita found out, charging thousands of dollars a session.
Well, when Mum died, I found out that he charged her about $24,000.
She paid that?
She paid that to him over 5 months.
Did you know that she was doing that?
Not till after she died.
I assess cases based on the weight of the case. Anna had a heavy case.
How do you justify that amount?
For people that heal, as Anna did, it's very justified, and they're thankful, and Anna voluntarily wrote me that testimonial. Voluntarily, in her own words.
Hi, I'm Anna Godfrey from New Zealand. I first heard of Ed Strachar through a lovely lady.
Anna did post a testimonial at the end of her initial 5-week course with him.
I've been able to stop the medications I was taking.
Many of the numerous symptoms I had have either gone or are greatly reduced. As I continue to work in the way Ed taught me, I know they will continue to improve.
But Anna didn't improve. A few months later, unable to shake the demons she believed had attacked her, she leaned more and more on her two healers, only to fall further.
I am going downhill fast and struggling to contain myself very well.
Anna wrote to the New Zealand healer Jill, whose real name is suppressed.
Oh my God, this pain and suffering is unbelievable. They have no mercy, and I'm f***ed. I can't keep going on like this. I'm starting to think the antidepressants and sleeping pills are a better option.
Jill replied, "No, Anna. You will get through this. You're a fighter." Meanwhile, Strachar wrote to Anna on Facebook.
"Dearest Anna has demons on her again. Get them off yourself while I read the sports pages. Do it now. I would suggest to stop looking for pills. Are you still helpless, little Anna, the victim?"
Why, when she was so vulnerable, why did you tell her that she got there by her own choice?
How else did she get there?
She was unwell.
She was unwell, but regardless, we all... Look, there's a certain principle here. Every human is the author of their own health or disease. She made her own choices.
Anna was seriously depressed.
Towards the end, yes. Anna was being targeted by witchcraft. She had demons on her. I told her that many times. And I showed her how to get rid of those. She either decided not to or just wasn't strong enough to be able to do it herself. That's the reality. It's a sad reality.
She trusted you.
With good reason. I cared for her, and she knew she could count on me.
You brainwashed her to believe that
Excuse
she
was... Excuse me? Excuse me? I brainwashed her? What f***ing planet are you on? Show me evidence of brainwashing. I want to see one piece of f***ing evidence on brainwashing. Really, I brainwashed her? Come on, you can't be that stupid, Janet McIntyre.
She believed that she was overwhelmed by demons, and there was nothing that she could do to fix herself.
Bullshit.
She needed medical help.
Oh, did she? Did the medicine help her? What was in her system? Spiritual healing or toxic medication with known suicidal tendencies?
In the last week of her life, Anna's husband Chris took her to a GP who prescribed medication, including antidepressants, which had been effective for her in the past.
These drugs were prescribed only immediately before she committed suicide.
Only immediately before, but the reality was they were given to her, and it could have been the straw that broke the camel's back.
The straw that broke the camel's back, Ed, could have been your words.
I don't think so.
Up next, a family up close with the man who guided Anna in her last days.
You're going to try and blame me?
He wouldn't know. He's blaming a family. I just feel so angry. I'll strangle him.
And the question that stumps Ed Strachar.
Do you have any empathy in your heart for this family?
To my beautiful, dear daughter Marita, I'm so sorry for breaking your heart. This will be a shock.
Marita Godfrey had no idea her mum was so unwell.
Not an inkling, really, of even that she was feeling down.
But her last written words hold a clue.
I have struggled so much these past months to overcome the monsters inside me, but I am losing this battle big time.
I needed answers. I needed answers for myself, for Dad, about why she would do this. It was just so out of character. I just felt like something had gone terribly wrong.
Only after accessing her mother's Facebook account did Marita learn about Ed Strachar. She and her dad, Chris, wanted to know what he had to say.
That family needs to look in the mirror at what kind of environment they were creating.
Only to find themselves in his firing line.
Who was she living with? Me? No, she was living with them. What does that tell you about them and their environment there? What does that tell you? You're going to try and blame me? Come on. Nobody could be that stupid.
We had a beautiful wife, a lovely wife, loving wife. He wouldn't know. He's blaming a family. I don't know. I just feel so angry. I'll strangle him. I'll strangle him.
You know, he says we don't know shit. Well, I knew Mum for 21 years. You only knew her online. You didn't know what type of person she was.
She was a loving, beautiful person.
A person suffering severe depression.
Do you have any empathy in your heart for this family?
I only know Anna, and I still know Anna. Her soul still exists. Her spirit is still alive. She is right here, right now.
I just can't believe, I cannot get my head around that Anna even engaged. She must...
Must have been desperate.
Must have been really desperate.
I think he pushed her to the edge.
Anna was teetering in the very last week of her life when she was messaging both her healers, telling Jill in New Zealand,
I would so much prefer to stay, but I'm struggling to see a way out.
And receiving a last message from Ed Strachar, these words.
I told Annie you have to overcome the fear of death.
Overcome the fear of death, and all other fears will go away. His last message to her on Facebook.
Overcoming fear is a huge accomplishment. Huge accomplishment. And anyone who's accomplished anything great knows that.
And do you think she might not have taken that literally?
Well, overcoming the fear of death is a very empowering thing. She may have misinterpreted that. And no doubt she probably did, or she saw that as, I don't want to live anymore and death isn't so bad. Maybe. I don't know. I can't answer for her.
Those two healers knew Anna's desperate state of mind better than anybody, but they told no one. The coroner was critical of the New Zealand healer, saying, while well-meaning, she was completely out of her depth. If she'd alerted family and the proper care was available, Anna might still be alive.
I hope she feels guilty, because she let Mum down big time. And, you know, we've lost so much. There's a big hole that's left.
Oh, big hole. Big hole.
As Sunday discovered, the woman is still advertising and charging for her soul healing services, despite a recommendation from the coroner not to.
She's shown no remorse.
What's your biggest fear with her?
That the same thing will happen to someone else, or people will go searching for advice in the wrong place, just like Mum did.
The coroner never contacted Strachar. But commenting on his CV and messages to Anna, the coroner called him unprofessional, unhelpful, unqualified, rude.
Do you think Anna's death could have been prevented?
Absolutely. I believe that with me knowing my mum and the love she had for us, I believe she would still be here if she hadn't had contact with them. And anyone who knows her knows that as well. She was vulnerable and brainwashed. And that's the truth.
Yeah.
Bye for now. Bye.
Well, the New Zealand healer who can't be named declined to answer our questions. This week, TVNZ filed an application in the High Court to lift her name suppression. We believe there's public interest in knowing who she is because she continues her soul healing practice when the coroner encouraged her to stop. The Australian and New Zealand College of Psychiatrists urges people feeling depressed and or suicidal to seek professional medical care. There's more information on our Facebook page. Now, in response to Ed Strachar's claim that antidepressants played a part in Anna's suicidal thoughts, the college says the risk is minimal, especially in people over the age of 25. They add no one should ever be blamed for their mental illness, as Anna was, because it can do more harm. The coroner's office said the case is closed and, as is usual practice, the coroner is unable to comment.